We have had several visitations from foreign presidents. Firstly, it was Macron from France. Then we have Merkel from Germany. Then recently we have May from Britain who are visiting the President of the Republic, trying to do business with this country, trying to see how they can help Nigeria to the burden of economic dislocation and political emancipation. And when you look at the political issue, you see that even the President of the US in one of the foreign magazines was called our President lifeless. And when you now look at that in contrast or in conjunction with the visitation from Macron, from Merkel from Germany, from Theresa May from England, then how do you see how this book can help Nigeria? Do you think we have a better position with Britain, Germany, and France?
Thank you very much, my brother. Sorry, sir. The three problems we have in Nigeria is the journalists. Journalists is one of the problems we have. Journalists and taxi driver, they are the same thing. You know, when you travel to a city you don't know before,
yes, sir.
The taxi driver can take you from your baby. When you say you are going to Adeniyi Jones,
okay, sir.
He will take you to Maryland and make rigmarole round, round. And then you go later, I saw this place the other day. I said, no, they look too. Don't worry, body a while, they look too. So that's the work of a journalist. Surely, Bobo, you both are so long when you're in the mini. Babangida Buhari, Oda be Agbaya. Should you hear?
Okay, sir.
Why Buhari is Agbaya is? When you look at the book of 1 King 13, 1 King 14, then 1 King 18, 1 King 19. Then when you look at the book of James, when you check James 5, verse 16, 17, 18. Then when you look at the book of Genesis 12, 1 to 5, that shows that Buhari is a fool. All those that are working with Buhari are fool.
Now therefore,
you see why Buhari or Shibajo is a foolish person. It's just one because of one thing.
Why, sir?
God created body, soul, and spirit. If you don't fornicate, you don't do anything bad, your life will have meaning. Before you can bring any president into a country, you need to commune with God. You have reputable and great prophets in this country. These people, they brought their bad legs. German, since night after independence, they said when they do road for us, we are to pay in what? In crude.
In oil.
In that crude, they will take it from here and go and refine it. From there, we get some particle to do wristwatch, to do body cream, to do all sorts of things in the crude they remove. And then on those roads, we have no gutter. That's to tell you, after 5 years, the roads with what? Become detached.
Damaged.
Yes. Do you know the asphalt we're using for the roads? Bitumen deposit in Ondo State is the second largest in the whole world.
You mean this Ondo State?
Ondo State here.
In southern Nigeria.
Then under the bitumen, there's a stockfish. Then under the bitumen, there's a petrol. The petrol of Ondo State is the best petrol in the whole world. The one of Canada still have sand and clay. The petrol in the Niger Delta cannot be compared with the petrol of other states. But because those people know their left and their right, we know our left from our right. Although we've not been able to be opportune to have good governor since the session of that state. We have the bastard Bodejo those days, who is a looter, who is a thief, who is a nine marauder, who is a bastard, who God will never favor for one day. He destroyed us. And we have ID Bemen. We have Ahibe. Ahibe can make love to yesterday newborn baby and make the person to grow.
But it's late now, sir.
And forget the bad, but these are the bad people they came to that state.
Sorry, sir.
Then from there, this state cannot make progress. The sand we have in the back of that, in Okitipupa area, in Igodolisa, that village is not going to be wretched. The sand will produce glass for 1,000 years. that old one who owe me, before we start digging from the, then all the water lilies are good for fertilizer. But they abandoned the states. In 1981-83, when there was a crisis in Lagos, a ship that took off from America burnt in the Bokoda without dredge. We deserve a seaport, but they turned it deaf eye. We deserve what? A refinery. They turned it deaf eyes. Then the useless governor that came there last, they call him Iroko or Getangarine. What's his name?
He's a great man, the former governor. No, engineer, Shagumi Mikosa. He's a doctor. No, sorry.
The mother, the wife is insane now with the repercussion of what he did.
No, Dr. Shagumi Mikosa.
Don't forget about this. He's an AF fatality in Osun State. Even the governor there, they are from the same club. They are all dupers. The two of them are dupers in Ibadan. They are Alaye boys when they were living in Ibadan. So, but I don't know the luck of Ondo State. That would make us to deserve all these barbaric, excommunicated, denounced, and useless, excommunicated human beings who did not know their left from their right. You know what I'm saying? That one came and said he's doing a BA program. Where they have been to? He said a BA program. We have been making more children. A BA program. Have you heard that before?
Yeah,
that is Mimico.
No, you can have
Mimico regime.
Yeah,
is that when you impregnate women,
you can we
pay for the atinenta?
Yes, sir.
Where we have the bitumen, we have the seaport, we have the glass factory, we have the oil palm. You know, we give the seedling of the palm kernel to Malaysia?
Many years ago.
That was 1976. We are the one that gave it to them. After taking those seeds from Anambra, red oil started from Midwest and rubber. If you throw rubber seed anywhere in the area, come back after 10 years, it's already a tree. But nobody is trying to even plant a tree there. So my brother, to come to your question.
Yeah, the president. And
the president is supposed not to bring these people. The problem is facing today. Obasanjo is a little bit tactical than him. In this way, Obasanjo believe in prophecy. Obasanjo believe in the Babalawos because he's part of them. You know, he was the one that bring the 1977 Ifa and all those women who can do jazz and jam. You know, he entered Obasanjo's head to a time. He said they should carry Ifa, all those cow horn. They should be manufacturing ashe and take to South Africa.
And not to stop apartheid.
Yes, and then we should carry anybody who knows how to put something in your Igbo shoe so that their leg can be elephantiasis. Or this. Listen.
To help about that, sir.
To know how diabolical, how nonsense or stupid the president was there. So now he now said, now, Buhari not supposed to bring these people here for now.
You mean Teresa May?
Yes. And, because these are the people who have been buying the refinery part from them ever since. They will sell the fake part to us. So after 3 days, we finish the refinery. It will break down again. We take our crude back to them. You know what I'm saying? That was what Germans are doing. That was what Britain are doing. You know, when you want to file a paper in London now, if a Nigerian needs to reappear,
yes, sir,
he will pay £2,000. If a Ghanaian or London, Ghana, Kenya, Zimbabwe, South Africa, they will pay £200.
Why, sir?
Yeah, because they said Nigerians are looters. Everybody will do everything to take their money. Do everything to what? To take their money.
Take Nigerian money from Nigeria.
Yeah, exactly.
Make him wretched.
And if you wanted to see, go and buy BA. First class BA.
British Airways.
Yes, in Ghana. And in Kenya. And in Sudabi. In Ethiopia. Yeah. It's times 10 what Nigeria is going to pay here. Baba can confirm. All of them can confirm.
You mean Nigeria pay times 10?
What? We pay more.
What a Kenyan pay?
A Ghanaian will pay. If a Ghanaian pay 5,000 naira, they will take 16,000 from Nigerians. You see the ratio?
It's callous.
So why they are doing that to us, we don't know. Although we are son of a king. They are doing this one to us because we are son of a king. I don't believe Buhari can fall into this trap again because Gowon fell into it. They are the one that gave Gowon the bad advice in those days that we have excess money. How on earth can father call his wife and children? Call my children, come, or we have excess money. Then they tag it Udoji and what?
No, just to take care of the permanent secretary, sir. For civil service.
It was from the front pocket. Gowon paid the debt of Britain in IMF loan without carrying us along. And we are the one they tricked to London. This London, they are fighting us now. They came here to what? To advise us to come.
Jesus.
And when you look at all their schools and tertiary institutions, Nigerians are there as lecturers. Many Nigerians are now in their what? In their psychiatric village now. Because they made them to go and do masters. But they cannot wash plates. They cannot work in any company. And they cannot pay. They have to be bringing the money from Nigeria. They must not generate any money from Britain. And these are the people you said, they are your guests. These are the people you said, they are your guests. It's not at this time we need a visitor. And if they can remove the return the money that is in their cover, we will not suffer. The looters, they have the looters to keep the money. And aiding and abetting is the citizen offense. Aiding and abetting is the same offense. What is special in Britain? An island. What is special in Ireland? What is special in France?
Germany.
What is special in all these things? I think we have a good leader. When Abacha was here, Abacha will not take that type of visitors. He may be a bad person to that, but all those areas, he did well for us. You know, they heard our plane. They heard Nigerian Airways there.
Yeah.
And they heard their plane here too.
Now, Abacha retaliated by...
Yes, immediately.
The British Airways.
And the Pope said he wanted to come and visit. Abacha said, no, this is not the time for the Pope to come. Yes, that is a leader. That is the voice of a leader. But this Buhari, I don't know what will become of him. You know, they said before, it's people's choice, not God's choice. So we don't need to stress too much about this matter. Anything he wanted, he can't, his days are numbered. His years are numbered. His hours are numbered. You know, he fought the late governor of Ondo State, Edoda Ajasi, and he lost the case. But now he should be preparing to bury another three houses. Because after Kumasi, Buhari, Shagari will go now, and two former governors. So, and when you look at his cabinet, it's not a thing to write home about. And these people you brought in, they are not our friends. But they were seeing that maybe we are having too much romance with the Chinese people. And the Chinese people is a curse on us. When you look at the book of Genesis 28 from verse 46, no, from 40. In verse 47 is very critical. He said, if we refuse to obey him as our Lord, appreciate what the Lord has done in Nigeria, he will make us to go and serve a
nation.
Country.
The nation.
A nation that we did not hear is what? The his language. Can somebody read?
Because you did not serve the Lord your God with joy and gladness of heart for the abundance of everything. Therefore, you shall serve your enemies, whom the Lord will send against you, in hunger, in thirsty, in nakedness, and in need of everything. And he will put a yoke of iron on your neck until he has destroyed you. The Lord will bring a nation against you from afar, from the end of the earth, as fish as the eagle flies, a nation whose language will not understand, a nation of praise, countenance, which does not respect the elderly, nor show favor to the young. They shall eat the increase of your livestock and the produce of your land until you are destroyed. They shall not live in your grain or new wine or oil or the increase of your cattle or the offerings of your flocks until they have destroyed you. They shall besiege you at all your gates until your...
The way the Chinese people are coming, they come with their driver. They come with their cook, they come with their houseboy, they come with everything. Then they don't create job, They are not creating jobs. Hmm. But these are the people we are romancing today. Although we don't have anywhere to go, and because we have tried with Britain, no result. With America, no result. With even when you look at the present governor, a president in America, he's more or less he's well in the morning and sick in the night.
Mm-hmm. You mean he's President Donald Trump?
Donald Trump. He's well in the morning and sick in the night, just like the story of that woman, the man that married somebody that has TB, and went to Asabe and married another woman. Yeah, the woman said, I have a problem, but I will not disclose. Mm. But when the time comes, you will know. Then when they now got to, they wanted to go out to, into a function. Then when they were at the bus stop waiting for the car, then the epilepsy strike. Then the woman fell down. He said, oh my God, the man had his head. He said, you cannot go anywhere, though. Is he your wife? He said, hey, but we never do the family diary. He said, nah, because you put on the same clothes. So wait until, so after 2 hours, the lady now put on his eye, and they use her eyes, and they use water to wash the face. Said, do you know this man? He said, that's my husband. He said, no, I'm not your wife. I'm not your husband. This is grace is too much. He called us Shito. He called our president lifeless human being.
Yes, sir.
Then what do we still need with the white people? So we can't do anything without seeing the whites. Of recent, I look at the soldiers they have just killed. For the past 3 or 4 weeks, they were just power touching between Burutai and the person who wanted to take over. Who they are screaming to take over from Burutai. We lose more than 180 soldiers. They are from women, they are from their parents. They are defending their father's land. And look at all this thing they are facing. During good luck, United regime. Is that they could be using life for life, flesh for political gains. I don't know where we're going. So we don't need all these people. I see the humiliating life they are giving to Nigeria in what? In Saudi Arabia. Look at the humiliating life they are giving to Nigeria in Libya. Look at the humiliating life they are giving to Nigeria in London, in Germany, and everywhere.
In fact, the president who told a German chancellor that the migrants are on their own.
They cannot be on their own, is a father. Because of Buhari, you see, Buhari cannot drop his old clothes. Buhari cannot what? He's a tribalistic person. He's a monopolist person. He behaved like animal at times. And because he did not have too much sense, people believe he's into. That's the problem. I can do more than Buhari. The only noise he's making that I don't touch the government money. Ooh, look. James 3:1-5. He said the law that says, don't commit adultery, was the one who said, don't kill your neighbors. And if you break one out of this law, you have break the whole law. He's only thinking, I'm the only most righteous person. You are not righteous until we get to God. If he wanted to claim righteousness, he didn't supposed to even be collecting salary. Yes. He was even using the Luther's plane and jet to do the campaign. It's still the same thing he's going to use now. How can you now fight corruption with all these things? And when you look at it, you say, where did you drop your old self? That's what we should ask Buhari. Where does he drop his old self? If his children is still having four power bike of millions and his garage, if all his children can be free in brain, looking for when the road of Abuja is going to be silent, when himself and his friends will be even riding the power bike. And when you check the book of 1 John 3:14, 1 John 11:1, 1 John 5:4 Buhari, then 11 to 12, then Romans and Revelation 21:1-5, 1 Peter 2:9, then Titus 3:5-6, Ephesians 5:14. That's for Buhari. Then Ephesians 4:23-24. Then Deuteronomy 32:1-18. Then Acts 10:34-48. He said, where did you draw your old self? This is what he did between Ediagwa himself. Presently now it's not friendly. There is not any good rapport between the family of Ediagwa himself. Because part of Ediagwa's children has now become a Christian. He's only having a good rapport between the wife of Abacha and himself because they are both Fulanese. So automatically all these things are not too fine. We are not comfortable. And he's still going to win again. He's still going to win again. God knows how he's doing his things. But we don't bring in anybody to come and visit us. He should try and be talking to the prophet. To let us, we advise him what to do. And you remember what is in the book of that 1 Kings 13?
Yes, sir.
Somebody go read 1 Kings 13 and 1 Kings 14. And when you look at 1 Kings 18 and 19, when the rain wanted to come, Elijah respect the king. He said, King, the rain is coming today. He said, wrong, the rain is coming today. A king cannot rule without a prophet. Even when Abbasada was in prison, when he opened his door for me to enter, then I gave him a message that in another 7 days' time, somebody is coming to give you a check of 9 digits. And the person brought it. He used his clothes to clean the bed for me to sit. Then half of his exercise book message was given. That, sir, engine of Mercedes, body of Volvo, you'll still be a president of Nigeria for another 8 years. And which came to pass. And when you look at it in the book of Amos 3, 4-8, Deuteronomy 18, 18, Deuteronomy 29, 29, then when you look at the book of Luke 1, from verse 30 to 36, then Luke 1, from verse 60 to 66, then when you look at John 8, then John 9, Luke 10, from verse 6 to 14, he's just there. He said, I'm the good shepherd. Before you go anywhere, you must commune from the prophet. Then that's what he said in the book of Isaiah 41, from verse 10 to 17. Then, with what we have seen in the book of Psalm 44, from verse 1 to 10, then Psalm 139, 1 to 8, Psalm 39, verse 1 to 5, he said, I will wash my way. Buhari is not washing his way. Can somebody read Psalm 39? Buhari is not washing his way. And he didn't even care for the masses.
Oh Lord,
yes.
You have searched me and know me.
Uh-huh.
You know my sitting down and my rising. Uh-huh. You understand my
Psalm 39, not 139.
Moni.
Uh-huh.
Emi o ma ke so na mi.
Ke
mi ko ma fi ahon mi se.
Yes.
Emi o fi danu para mi lenu.
Nigba
ti na bubu ba nbe niwaju mi. O fi dake ya di.
O
ti le pa enu mi mo kuro loro e. Oro rere.
Yes.
Emi ni je mi si iru soke.
Aya
mi gbona ninu mi.
Nigba
ti mi ronu.
Ina
ran.
Nigba
na ni mo fi ahon mi soro.
Oluwa.
Je ke mi ko mo pin mi ati iwon ojo mi o ti ri.
Ke
mi ko le mo igba ti
We need God intervention. We need God what?
Intervention.
They should talk to him. Because he said how the mighty fall is in the book of 2 Samuel. 2 Samuel 1 from 4 to 10. 2 Samuel 2 from 1 to 8. Then 2 Samuel 10, 11. Then Daniel 3 from verse 6, from verse 10 to 22. Daniel 4, 1 to 8. Daniel 5, verse 10 to 17. But in Daniel 1, verse 8, he said, I will not eat the what? The food they prepare in the palace. Because I do not want to spoil my credibility. He should be very careful. Because the end is near. The end is what? Is near. For Buhari, for Obasanjo, for Daduma, for Emir of Kano, for all these people. Because he said, we can take the righteous before his days. And these people are not righteous. The only problem they have is Nigeria. How to loot and loot and loot and loot and loot and loot. This man has been, there's a man who has been recommending president for us for the past 20 years. Because we can't get any good presidency. Because himself is bad. He brought in Yadua. Yadua was buried in Saudi Arabia. Nigerians were thinking they buried Yadua in Nigeria. No, buried in Saudi Arabia. America heard about his death before Nigerians.